Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will understand about the instrumentation amplifier. Now this instrumentation amplifier is a one kind of differential amplifier, but it has a very high gain as well as very high common mode rejection ratio and very high input impedance. And this instrumentation amplifier is used in industrial applications as well as in test and measurement circuits. So now in this video, let us understand how this instrumentation amplifier is different from the differential amplifier, which is designed using the op-amp, and in certain industrial applications, why this instrumentation amplifier is preferred over the differential amplifier. So first of all, let us see some problems that we can face if we use this normal differential amplifier in certain industrial applications. So now in many industrial applications, it is required to measure the certain parameters like temperature, flow, humidity, etc. And these parameters are measured using the transducers like RTD, strain gauge and thermocouples. So these transducers convert the measured parameter into the electrical signals. And many times to convert this measured parameter into the electrical signals, these bridge circuits are used. For example, if we take the case of RTD, in RTD as the temperature changes, the resistance of RTD will also change. So if we connect this RTD at one of the arm of this bridge circuit, then the resistance of this particular arm will change according to the temperature, and accordingly the voltage that is generated at particular node will also change. So if we measure the voltage across these two terminals A and B, then the voltage will change according to the temperature, and this generated differential voltage can be amplified using the differential amplifier. Now many times in industrial applications, it is quite possible that the location where these measurements are carried out and the locations where these sensors are deployed are quite far away from each other. So in this case, it is quite possible that the noise or the interference signal will get superimposed over the measured signal. And to avoid the problem of this noise or interference, many times the signal is measured using the differential measurement technique. For example, if we take the case of this bridge circuit, the output that we are getting through this bridge circuit is also differential signal, and this differential signal further can be amplified using the amplifier. So as you can see over here, the output of this bridge circuit is given to this differential amplifier. So the advantage of this differential amplifier is that whatever common mode noise or the common mode interference signal which appears at the two terminal of this differential amplifier should ideally get eliminated, and only the differential signal across the two terminal should get amplified. So if VA and VB are the voltages that appears across the two terminal of this differential amplifier, then the output of this differential amplifier can be given by this expression. So at the non-inverting terminal, the voltage will be equal to this R4 divided by R3 plus R4 times the voltage VA, and that voltage will get amplified by the factor of 1 plus R2 divided by R1. Similarly, the output voltage because of the input at this inverting terminal will be equal to minus R2 divided by R1 times this voltage VB. So if we rearrange these terms, then we can write this same expression like this. Now here, if we assume that the ratio of this R4 by R3 is equal to this ratio of R2 by R1, in that case, the output voltage can be given by the expression R2 divided by R1 times the voltage VA minus VB. So in this case, as you can see, the output voltage Vout will be the difference between the two input signals multiplied by the gain of this circuit. Now so far we have assumed that there is no common mode voltage present at the input terminals. But if common mode voltage is also present along with the differential input voltage, in that case, in general, the output voltage of this differential amplifier can be given by this expression. So the differential input voltage will get amplified by the differential gain, while the common mode voltage will get amplified by the common mode gain. Now in this case, suppose if common mode voltage is also present, then we can say that the voltage VA will be equal to this common mode voltage VCM plus VD by 2, and likewise this voltage VB will be equal to VCM minus VD by 2. So if we assume that the ratio of R4 divided by R3 that is equal to R2 divided by R1, in that case the output voltage Vout will be equal to R2 divided by R1 times this voltage VA minus VB. And if we put these two values of VA and VB, then the output voltage Vout will be equal to R2 divided by R1 times this differential voltage VD. So if we assume that this op-amp is ideal, in that case, this circuit should amplify only differential input signal and it should reject the common mode signal. But even if we assume this op-amp as ideal, then also because of the mismatch between these resistor pairs, the common mode signal will also present at the output terminal. So even if there is a 1% error in any of the resistors, then also the common mode rejection ratio will get affected and the common mode signal will present at the output terminal. And this particular scenario will become critical when your differential input signal is very small and the common mode signal which is present at the two input terminal is larger than the differential signal. So let us take some values of these resistors as well as the input voltages and let us see how the mismatch between these resistor pairs can affect the output voltage. So here let us assume that the resistance R1 and R3 are 1 kilo ohm, while the resistor R2 is equal to 10 kilo ohm. And here we are assuming that there is a 1% error in this resistor R4. So instead of 10 kilo ohm, the value of this R4 is equal to 10.1 kilo ohm. And the differential input to this differential amplifier is equal to 10 millivolt, while the common mode input to this differential amplifier is equal to 1 volt. So in this case, let us find out the output voltage of this differential amplifier. Now we know that the output of this differential amplifier can be given by this expression. And if you put the value of these four resistors in this expression, then we will get the output voltage V out as 10.009 times this voltage VA plus 10 times this voltage VB. So now let us put the value of this VA and VB in terms of this common mode voltage and the differential input voltage. So if we put the value of this V and VB, then we will get the output voltage V out as 0.009 times the common mode voltage plus 10.0045 times this differential input voltage. And if we compare this expression with this expression, then we can say that the common mode gain of this circuit will be equal to 0.009, while the differential gain will be equal to 10.0045. And if we find the common mode rejection ratio, that is the ratio of this differential gain and the common mode gain, then that will be equal to roughly around 61 dB. So ideally, this common mode rejection ratio should be infinite, but because of the slight mismatch in any of this resistor, the value of this common mode rejection ratio has been reduced to 61 dB. Now let us see how it will affect the output voltage. So here, the value of this common mode voltage is equal to 1 volt. So this common mode voltage will get amplified by this factor. And because of that, the output voltage V out will be equal to 9 millivolt, while the differential input to this circuit is 10 millivolt. So it will be amplified by the factor of 10. So at the output, we will have a 9 millivolt because of this common mode signal and almost 100 millivolt because of this differential input signal. So as you can see, 9% error will get introduced in the output voltage, and it will further increase if there is a mismatch between more than one resistors or if the common mode signal that is present at the input terminal is more than 1 volt. So in that case, this error will further increase. So as you can see over here, the mismatch between the resistors can affect the output drastically and it can reduce the common mode rejection ratio of this differential amplifier. So the one way to solve this problem is to use the monolithic ICs for this differential amplifier. So one can use readily available differential amplifier ICs like AD629 and INA106. So in these ICs, the resistors are fabricated in the IC itself. And in these ICs, the ratios of these resistors are matched quite accurately. So using these ICs, you can increase the common mode rejection ratio and you can minimize the error in the output voltage. So even if we use such monolithic ICs for this differential amplifier, then also you will face the problem of this input impedance. Because if you see over here, the input impedance at this inverting terminal is equal to R1, while the input impedance of this differential amplifier at this non-inverting terminal will be equal to R3 plus R4. So if these input impedances are comparable to the resistance of this bridge circuit, in that case, the differential input that is available at the two input terminal will also reduce. So it is highly required that the input impedance of this differential amplifier should be very high. So one way we can solve this problem is to use the buffers before the inputs. So if we use the buffer circuits, then we can increase the input impedance of this differential amplifier. So in this way, by using this buffer circuits along with this monolithic ICs, we can solve the problem of this input impedance as well as the problem of this mismatch between the resistor pairs. But the problem with these monolithic ICs are that the gain that is provided by these ICs are fixed. So you cannot change the gain of this differential amplifier. And in your application, if you want to change the gain, then using these ICs you cannot change the gain. So one way we can avoid this problem is by using the non-inverting op-amps instead of these buffer circuits. So the same circuit can be represented like this. So in these circuits, the initial gain can be provided by these non-inverting buffers. But the problem with the circuit is that along with the differential input signal, the common mode input signal will also get amplified. So you will not get any improvement in the signal to noise ratio. Apart from that, in this circuit, you also need to match these four resistors, because if there is a slight mismatch in these resistors, then once again, the common mode rejection ratio of this circuit will get compromised. So these are the problems that you face with this differential amplifier circuits. And the one way we can avoid this problem is by using the instrumentation amplifier. So in terms of the circuit, if you see, there is only one difference between this circuit and this circuit. So over here, this resistor RG is common between the two op-amps. Now the advantage of this configuration is that only the differential input signal will get amplified by these op-amps, while the common mode signal will pass as it is. So this instrumentation amplifier is available in a IC format. And except this resistance RG, all the resistors are fabricated internally. And because they are fabricated internally, they are highly matched. So just by connecting this resistor RG externally, we can set the gain of this instrumentation amplifier. So for this configuration, if we assume that this R5 is equal to R6 and the ratio of this R4 by R3 and R2 by R1 are matched, in that case, the output voltage Vout can be given by this expression. So now let us derive this expression. And during the derivation, let us also understand how this circuit will amplify the differential input signal and it will pass the common mode signal as it is. And using this, how we can improve the common mode rejection ratio of the circuit. Now in this circuit, let us assume that the voltage at this node is equal to VB dash and the voltage at this node is equal to VA dash. So the output voltage V out can be given by the expression R2 divided by R1 times this voltage VA dash minus VB dash, provided the resistance R4 divided by R3 that is equal to R2 divided by R1. So first of all, we need to find the difference between this VA dash and the VB dash voltages. Now, if you observe this circuit, the voltage at this node will be equal to VB, because here we are assuming that all the op-amps are ideal. So whatever voltage that appears at this terminal, the same voltage will also appear at this terminal. And likewise, the voltage at this node will be equal to voltage VA. So from this, we can say that the current that is flowing through this resistor RG will be equal to VB minus VA divided by this resistance RG. And let us say this current is equal to IG. So we can say that current IG will be equal to VB minus VA divided by this resistance RG. Now the same current IG will also flow through this resistance R5 and R6, because here we are assuming the op-amps are ideal. So no current is flowing into the op-amp terminals. So we can say that the same current IG is flowing through this resistor R5, RG and R6. And using this, we can find the difference between this voltage VB dash and VA dash. So we can say that VB dash minus VA dash will be equal to this current IG times resistance R5 plus RG plus R6. And if we assume that this resistance R5 is equal to R6, in that case, we can say that VB dash minus VA dash will be equal to IG times 2 times this resistance R5 plus RG. So now if you put the value of this current IG from this expression, then we can write VB dash minus VA dash will be equal to VB minus VA multiplied by 1 plus 2 times R5 divided by this resistance RG. Or we can say that VA dash minus VB dash will be equal to VA minus VB times 1 plus 2 times R5 divided by this resistance RG. So this is the voltage that will be present between the two input terminals of this differential amplifier, and the output voltage Vout will be equal to R2 divided by R1 times this voltage VA dash minus VB dash, that is equal to R2 divided by R1 times 1 plus 2 times this resistance RF divided by RG times this voltage VA minus VB. So in this way, this differential input will get amplified using this instrumentation amplifier. So now let us also understand how this instrumentation amplifier will pass the common mode voltage as it is, and it will only amplify the differential input signal. So now let us say the common mode voltage VCM is present at these two terminals. So the same voltage will also present at these two terminals. Now because the voltage at these two terminals is same, so no current will flow through this resistance RG. And because of that, we can say that the no current is also flowing through this resistor R5 and R6. And in a way, we can say that the same voltage is also present at this terminal and this terminal as well. So we can say that for the common mode voltage, these two amplifiers will act as a buffer or a unity follower, while it will amplify only the differential input signals. So in this way, by using this instrumentation amplifier, the common mode rejection ratio of the circuit can be further increased. And this instrumentation amplifier is particularly useful in an environment where the differential input signal is very small and the common mode input signal, which is present at the two terminals, is larger than the differential input signals. And that is why this instrumentation amplifier is preferred over the differential amplifier in industrial as well as the test and measurement circuits. So I hope in this video you understood the importance of this instrumentation amplifier and why this instrumentation amplifier is preferred over the differential amplifier in certain applications. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.